Hello and welcome back to Prison Architect. So, yeah. One guy just got murdered like 5 seconds ago. He's dead. And Drew Lim, of course. We're still finding contraband. And of course, we gotta fix someone's toilet because he screwed it up. And that, it's all peachy. We can check the finance, we can check the. Well, we are making a lot of money here. Policy. Oh, meal quality. Are we having medium? You're right, the medium. That's really good. Peril cutoff. Really? Really? So, prisoners below 33% chance of reoffending will be released. 1 in 3 chance? Oh, come on. You're not that picky. Anyone can go. If they serve their time, then they can go. Well, I guess that's technically what not a parole hearing is about. You need to prove yourself to be that you deserve to be let out early. What else we have here? Grants, policy, cell quality ratings, what is that? Oh, really? So, prisoners with good behavior get better cells? Okay. Also, I was checking these tabs as well. The bureaucracy, of course. We can just maybe check out employment. But we are doing the offshore tax haven. Also, prison grading. Would you look at that? So, we are somewhat punishing people. Not a whole lot. A reform policy is exactly how I wanted it to be. But it's still very generous. 33% reoffending rate. Well, considering that we basically let out nobody, and only people who got out escaped, holy shit. 131 guys escaped, and 26 guys died? We're getting fired for sure. Security's -3. Whatever security rating that is. And health is not the worst. And our reoffending rate just got better. Well, lower. Not necessarily better. We want some bad boys. You know. Anyhow. Also, I was thinking that I might not just let this series run for whoever, for however long it could run. I don't know, I might just end that after a month. Like a day 30 or something like that. Just because it... we're kind of running out extra things to do. I don't know, I'm just gonna see. So, holy shit! Really? 3 deaths just today? That's crazy. I'm probably gonna get sacked before that. Could even consider this thing. Holy shit. What do we have to do? Because I'm a little bit running out of things to build and things to play around with. Of course I could micromanage it a little bit. Put down some sofas, but for the most part, I kind of run out of things to do. Of course I can make some... Try to make this, redesign the whole prison fancy, but if I'm doing that, I'd rather just start from fresh. If you guys understand that. Because in this playthrough, at very least, I was a bit confused of what to do. At least early on, and now I have a better understanding. So I just tried to have it all. And just tried to fit it all. Also, it was a smaller map. But let's get back to the gameplay, because I definitely plan to play around for a little bit longer. Maybe we can release some guys, that would be great. Just to see how it goes. Pre-fire mode, problem not report. So, what is this? Oh, no recent deaths? Holy shit. Oh, we can't sell the prison. So, selling the prison is an option. I guess that is just ending the game on your own. Reschedule all programs. Occult therapy. Maybe the guy who were qualified for the general education qualification, probably, he just escaped. Maybe he was the one who figured out the secret plan to bust out, dig a hole from under the toilet. On drugs? Holy crap. So we can also customize the punishment. Not that important, but it's an option. Oh, Supermax death row. All available. Well, we're taking all available, guys. Because the game could be easier if I'm just really, really careful. Of course, the less prisoner that I have, the less could go wrong, of course. It seems like every single guard has a taser. Maybe not. Not two. They're just too dumb to have tasers. Not sure why. Or no. Those are the doggy guys. Never mind. They initially failed. Some of them did fail the test, but seems like all of them passed by now. And they are certainly paranoid as hell. For good reason, I must add. Holy shit, these prisoners are crafty. Digging tunnels from toilets. That move never gets old. But, oh shit. We need to. Also, more deaths. Oliver Massey, rest in peace. Actually, this is one of the better upgrades available. This allows you to just. It's kind of like patrol, but it just allows you to designate a guide to one location and he will just keep checking it. That's pretty good in, well, it has obvious value. We're gonna just put two guys over here, two guys over here, and just keep checking these bloody prisoners because screw them. Because they are really crafty and if we are not paying attention then they're just gonna, well, tunnel from toilet. We certainly know that trick. Anyhow, I believe library still didn't have a single visitor. I'm not sure what the deal with that. Maybe those books are not appropriate for them. Maybe we should get some Playboy magazines, I believe. If those are still a thing. Are those are still a thing? Let me in the comment section. I have no idea. Maybe they are. They must be. Right, might be a little somewhat sticky after a while, but I'm pretty sure they would be still the most requested literature. So to speak. What else we have? Oh, these are just special cells, but I guess we can change the rules of this. Maybe shared. I don't know. Let's just make it Minsec only. And actually, just have these for protected only. Maybe make that one Minsec and that should be fine. Free cells unused, just in case I wanna protect someone. And I guess I should check that if there is actually someone here. Ex law enforcement instigator. He's a snitch. Can we put him in protective custody? I did it. Bunch of gang members, instigators. Wow. Skill fighter. Wow, a lot of gang members. Holy crap. Okay, what's going on here? We got the They don't have names? How disappointing. What is this? I don't know. This is the school guys, the ducks, and the crossers. That's how they are. That's who they are. So anyway, so it looks like the ducks are the dominant gang in this joint. That doesn't surprise me at all. So if you were to come to this prison, you would definitely wanna have an eye out for them. 47 guys are coming. Holy shit! These are completely insane numbers. How many guys are in here? I guess we can check the room quality stat. 178. That's insane. Can we increase it with more beds? I'm not sure. I'm actually suspect that the answer is no. No? What's the problem? No canteens accessible by this cell? That's kind of the point. Now they shouldn't need to have anywhere to eat, because they are just there temporarily. Visitation, fine. A parole hearing! I wanna see that! Food! I'm gonna translate this. What the fuck he just said? Food! That's parole, right? Yes, that is parole. I like food. That guy is so stinky and loves food right hell. I would like to sleep with you. Food. I'm just going. Oh shit, he's released! Of course. Where is it? I left it like that, right? Shit. Oh boy, something's up. Oh, maybe they don't like the guy who got released. Just a word of warning, if you're a prisoner and just got released, you probably don't want to just run past the Mexican guys and just say like, hell yeah, I got released! And get murdered right away. Three deaths, yeah. I'm not sure if the guy who got released got murdered, but there's a chance. Anyway, how the parole hearing work? Parole hearings work? I want to check it out, so... where is it? Start. How do we do this? Well, we need to check the policy. Policy tab. Yes, that's what we want. Parole policy. Everybody is released. That will improve our reputation. This is the place every prisoner wants to go. So what we say? I want some booze. That's good. These guys just here for no reason. Want more booze, I guess? Reoffend chance? Can we check that? Reoffending chance 52%. Booze and kill people? I'm stinky. I'm really stinky, guys. I'm telling you. We have a really good poker face. And they're just gonna check their books after this session and... looks like he's gonna get released! I want some booze, and I would like to take a shower. Oh yeah, I'm released! Hell yeah! Awesome! This is your lucky day. So basically, anyone can just... he's just running away. Great. Can we just, lock him up for a day. It's like, yeah! No! He served 11 years! He really did! He deserves to go! Oh, who's that? Just a visitor. Enjoy your freedom, man. Warren Buckton. I really regret not having the parole hearings sooner. Oh, come on. We gotta check this out. Sean Holdaway. Sean? You have a girlfriend? He was joyriding. He wants food, like a lot. And this is actually kind of reasonable. And yeah, recovering alcoholic. This is reasonable. He's an idiot, drunken driver. Young Guinea drunken driver, and he's gonna get released after serving most of his sentence, and he's gonna feel pretty good about it. Probably gonna be still a drunken driver, but in a more limited way. Enjoy your freedom, dude. You only have two guys: parole officer, parole lawyer. can we have more of these guys? Oh yeah, go! Oh, it's not going yet. Still, they're still talking about it. I wanna see what's up. I want some food. And more food, I guess.
Sleep.
This is the perfect. We see the classroom as well. Oh, spirituality? That's interesting topic. Oh, even the Maxed guys are coming. And the guy's released, right? He's making a run for it. Sean, hold away! Oh, his sentence got reduced to 1 year. Okay, well, I guess. So his sentence got reduced, so he actually served it. And he's just out. That's like that. What's the next? Is the next guy? I just wanna see if something's gonna be. Oh, this is very reasonable. Mainly because they didn't have the chance to have parole hearings. What kind of reoffend chance? Only 31%. He served most of his punishment. He served almost all of it, except 2 months, or like, about 2 months. So looks good. There's really not much point keeping him around. Well, he's definitely a regular in prisons. Not sure how he even managed to serve that much time. 16 years plus 3? 19 years. 24 years served in prisons. How? That's crazy. Yeah, 17 year plus. So 22 years. So he's at it since he's 17. Not even sure how he had time to actually do any of these things. Crazy. What? And he managed to have a wife and a son? And a daughter? How? This is crazy. I'd rather not speculate about his life. Unless he had some time with his wife. I don't know what he did. I guess he just got a wife when he was 17. Then had a child with her. Then got into jail. Then got out, and they made another child, and he got fucking locked up again, and now he's getting released. Wonder what he's gonna do with his life now. Good one, mate, but you kinda deserve to get out. And this is it, just crushing stories. Some of them are gonna be tougher. Like, I don't know. Some guys that probably truly deserve to be here. Graham Tyson. Alright. So, looks like the parole hearings are done for today. Is there a way to have more of those things? Because my guests truly deserve it. They'd like to give me a bad rap, but come on. My guests deserve it. Serious injury. Needs job. These are mad. As I said, I did care for most of their needs. Even with the guys coming in. Still handled. I guess I could get more food, but... Wow. We have enough food. It's mostly the problem that they just don't get there to eat the food. Or they all gang up on this place that doesn't have that much food. Oh, shit. They are still at it. Jesus. Almost dead, of course. Served 15 years. And he's dead now. Remove supply of stolen goods. We are still doing that. And having one guy passing the general education course is proving to be a problem. We had one guy. We actually had a guy. But he escaped the prison. He was too smart. He was too smart for the course. And he's probably back to crime right now. What the hell? That's crazy. 31 years for those things. Perjury, possession again. Holy shit. Sentenced to 31 years for multiple crimes, including possession, intent to supply, possession, and perjury. Is this about drugs? Still, it's really extreme. I hope this is completely made up. Because having drugs on you is one thing, whatever. That intent to supply, okay, it's something, maybe. Perjury? That's just kind of crazy. Not sure how harshly that is treated. But 31 years seems like a lot of time. And how the hell did he serve 11 years from it? So he did these... So when he was 14 year old, he was selling some drugs, lied about it, and now he's locked up till he's a, well, not really an old man, but he's really, well, it's just cruel. It's crazy. What is that? Criminal damage and perjury? Oh, what is, something's happening, no? Blackmail. It's just sad to see these criminals just getting back to crime because that's all they know. Because the system fails them. Holy shit, so many deaths. We don't teach them how to do better. But we try. But it's just, well, we try to teach them. We truly try to teach them, but it is just not working out. We are just not qualified. Well, we are qualified to release them, so we're gonna check that out. So if this guy wants some, oh really, he's gonna get released? Death by dangerous driving? Well, so he's a reckless driver who killed someone and got 13 years for it. And but he was 20 years old, and he's gonna get released. Yeah, he has a very low reoffending chance, so he got locked up. But it's not like it was unintentional. It was extremely reckless, but unintentional. And he's like, hell yeah, I'm out. Still, he killed someone. It's an interesting topic because, well, I don't really want to go into it because our job is just to keep the guys here. But, what if he was 100% serious about. What if he killed someone by accident? But, or maybe not accident, but foolishness. But how much of a punishment does he deserve? Because if one guy is locked up for like a lot of years, for tens of years, for like 30 years, 40 years, just because of an accident. Well, not really an accident, for being his own stupidity, but not really his he's not really evil, he's just stupid. So he was a 20-year-old driver and who hit someone. And he probably regretted that. Yeah, well, he definitely regretted that big time, but well, he got punished for it, and I don't know. I'm just curious who's gonna come to the table. Oh, we found some scissors. Holy shit, these guys. Oh, what's up, Shades? Shine, remember me everything. Every time. Or every time. Oh, he's driving under influence and he's getting released. Holy shit. Really? What a coincidence. Holy shit, this guy. Why are you fooling around with a scissor? I don't know. They're just waiting for a prisoner, but no one's coming? Why? Are the guards supposed to bring them here? How are we doing with their needs? Pretty fine. Except maybe the food. Maybe we can up the food quantity or quality? Can we do that? Very, could we do that? Meal variety. That's only variety, not quantity. That's quantity, not quality. Let's make it high. So you guys get more. How about that? It's on me. You guys can eat. Like, oh, maybe not on me. You can hook that up. Overall, this kind of works pretty well. Really well. Of course, some blood stains here and there from few murders, but that just keeps the guys on their toes. We can hear the dogs barking all the time. Maybe they find some contraband and we finally... Oh, this is tool cleanup. Stolen goods. Maybe we can feed all the prisoners. I want to check it out if this works out. Oh, someone's getting released. I'm curious about him. Oh, he got released already for arson. He plead not guilty. Oh, what reoffending chance he has. Now, for example, arson is intentional. He wasn't just stupid, he intentionally did it. But what is, well, he's a reoffending chance of 2%. Major factor. Oh, okay. That's good. So he... 15 years? What did he burn? What did he light on fire? I guess no one got hurt, but he still burned something. But 15 years for that? I guess we really don't know. We just don't have all the information. That's not a job. Death by dangerous driving. Well, that's really something. And before that, he already served 9 years. So he was 18 years old. Maybe probably 18 years old, or maybe got out and did this thing, death by dangerous driving. So he has a long history of dangerously driving. 3 offense chance of blow. Okay. Wow, this is really something. Okay. Gotta check the other canteen as well. And holy shit. This is popular. So we don't have... What's the problem? Do we need more... serving tables? I don't know. Let's put down more serving tables. So that might just make the cooks prepare more food. I don't know. That's my best guess. Because it seems like they have a lot of ingredients unused, a whole lot of them, and they just didn't have enough space to really place the food. Oh, what the hell? What are we looking for? Another table. Come on. I don't see it. Come on, highlight it for me. Can do it. Jesus. Oh, maybe. Why is it working? I just want something like that. Can I have it? Maybe not. Why not? Oh, it's working right now. We wanna. Serving table. Can we put it here? Can they... Holy shit, 30 escapes today! How? Where? Really? 3 fire mode! Lockdown! Shakedown! Bang them up! Bang up! More escapees! I thought I was really good. I thought I was really onto something with these fences. But I guess I'm not. Holy crap. They did it. They managed to dig a tunnel over there. Someone died. But yes, we are in free fire mode. Maybe it's unfair to punish the guys who are inside for the escape of the... Come on, don't tell me you did it from this toilet. That would be the worst. Actually, we can just deploy some guys. I should have done that a long time ago. A long, long, long time ago. Yeah, we should. That's more like it. I don't know why I didn't do that before, because this is one of the key features of the game. At least this is something that I used in the past. But this is a good time to take a break, and next time we're gonna check out what the frick is up with this escape. So hope you guys had fun, and see you in the next one, and have a good one, guys.